Geometry, 10.4 practice assignment, right? And it was something I signed yesterday. So we'll go through questions, and I'll ask you to read and participate. Okay. We talked about a couple of theorems. One of them was the chord-tangent theorem, or tangent-chord theorem. We talked about the tangent-tangent theorem. We talked about the tangent-secant theorem and the secant-secant theorem, right? Or the secant theorem. And so this looks like it's going to be the chord-tangent theorem. So I will overlap the key components of this figure to help us remember what it is we're using, okay? So let's change the line style here. Oops, that didn't work. Let's try it again. There we go. Uh-huh. And watch what I do here, guys. This is my chord, right? That's my chord. And my tangent, right, Rennie? My tangent is from here to here. So you guys see that angle called 1? Yeah? Okay, there's an arc that's inside or interior that angle. And again, the arc that's created, it was created by the chord itself, right? So let's highlight the arc that's inside that angle. You guys see that? So that chord breaks up this circle into two chords, or two arcs, the minor and the major. The major is inside the angle called 1. If that's 220 degrees, what do we do to find the measure of angle 1? You remember? Divide it by what? That's right, Jeremy. He's got it. You divide by 2. So the pattern is, hey, to find the angle, you divide by 2. Isn't that easy? Hey, what if I gave you the angle but not the arc? How would you find the arc measure? You multiply by 2. So if that was missing, you would multiply by 2. Right? So either divide or multiply depending on what information is given. Simple concept, okay? All right, next question. Okay, volunteer. Anybody like to walk me through the process of finding angle 2? And I think I cut some information off, didn't I? Anybody have that written down? What was the measure of this arc? Yes. Oh, was that given? That wasn't given? Okay, so we're supposed to know that. There you go, Kenneth. Way to go, man. So here's what we know. We know that the diameter, actually a chord, right, passing through the center circle. So that's a semicircle, which means that even though the information was not given, that has to be 180 degrees. So the measure of that arc is 180 degrees, which tells us that the chord, oops, wrong way. It tells us that the chord and the tangent line create this angle called 2. This arc is interior to angle 2, and so this is the right arc that we're looking at here. Both of them are 180, though, huh? So what's half of 180?
90.
Oh, hey, that reminds me of a theorem. Isn't the tangent line always perpendicular to the radius?
Yeah.
Isn't this the radius here? Yeah? Center to the point of tangency? Yeah, so we know that has to be 90 degrees. So the measure of angle 2 is 90 degrees. Okay, good stuff. Right. It'll destroy the file and corrupt it. Anyway, we're back. Number 12, the measure of ABC. My question is this. Is that a major or minor arc? Arc ABC, what do you think? 3 points. To name the arc guarantees it's a major arc, right? So it's major, is it more than 180 or less than 180? No, dongle's gone. Wish. If you find it for me, you let me know. Cool. So it sounds like you guys said it's a major arc, okay? The major arc. And so we're supposed to find that. We don't know what it is. Well, here's what I do know. I know that the angle is 54. So I think I'm going to just kind of highlight, using my voice here, highlight the information that will guide me through this. They don't make this a chord, do they? But that's okay, I'll make it a chord. How's that? So, if this is 54, you notice that I had to use those endpoints to create the arc. If that arc, well, the arc's not 54, what's 54? Is it the arc or the angle? So what do I do to find the arc measure? Double it, so what's double 54? So if that's 108, is there enough information to find the major arc? How do you know that? How do you know there's enough information? What do you know? They don't tell it to you, but you know it. There you go. That's the complete revolution, or all of the arcs on the circle, right? One complete revolution would be 360, right, in terms of degree measure. And so we already have 108. And subtracting that from 360 allows us to find the arc measure ABC. So again, the idea is that you double 54 to get 108, use 108, subtract that from 360 to get the major arc measure ABC, which is 252. Any questions? Now, I know some of you said you didn't get this done last night. Are you getting it done now? You're getting it done now, yeah? Yeah, okay. Even if you were absent yesterday, are you kind of feeling how you kind of get what we're doing? We're doubling to find the arc measure. Right? Okay, good. Excuse me. Okay, Monica, will you please read the directions? Excellent. So I got to use algebra right now. I think sometimes it's a little confusing when they say find the value of x, and then you don't see x anywhere on the picture, on the diagram. So it says that x is arc measure what? So I'm going to highlight that. A over to B. You notice that it's only two letters, so it's not ACB. It's this side. So I call that x. Make sense? Now, well, how am I going to find that? Well, anybody have a strategy? I have an idea, but I'm not sure if it makes sense. It makes sense to me, but I'm not sure if it makes sense to you. So does anybody have any idea what I need to do to find arc measure AB? Can I give you a hint?
Yeah.
Here's my hint. You see 96? That's that angle. You see this angle here? Yeah, you can double it. There's two ways to do it. You can use that angle to help you find X, the unknown, or another creative idea would be to just take the major arc, find it, to help you find X. So there's two ways of doing this. It's up to you. Which way do you want to find the other missing angle or the arc measure here, ACB? What do you want to do? You want to find the other angle here?
Yeah.
Let's try that. So this is a little different. These two angles are linear pairs, which means that they are supplementary, 180 degrees. So if you take 96 and subtract it from 180, right? You get 84. Let me erase that. What's 84? Is it the angle or the arc? The angle. This angle here is 84 degrees. So what do you do to 84? Do you divide it by 2 or multiply by 2 to find the arc measure? You multiply by 2. So 84 times 2 is, there you go. Show the work. And so X is 168. job. Any questions? The other technique would be to take 96 and double it. What do you get? $192, right? And then you stick, yeah, you subtract that from 360. $3, $15, $10, $1, $6. Same answer. That's the other way, okay? When you work these questions out, I think it's important. I think it's very important that you don't think that you just show the work and be okay with that, like the algebra. But you have to show that you're actually using the diagram to find the algebra, right, to solve it. So I would always draw the diagram, because if you don't draw it, I know it's, you know, quicker to not draw it, but if you don't draw it, you can make a mistake and not realize that you made the mistake. So drawing it out, you know, it's hard to draw circles. I'm not very good at drawing them, so I copy paste. But, you know, do the best you can to sketch the picture and then add the information and think about what it is you do to solve for the information that you're trying to find. So when we're done, maybe, but we still have some notes to take. So here's what I want to do. Pay attention. Watch closely. I want to find the measure of arc HJK. So I highlight that. HJK. So this is it. H over to J over to K. So now I know what I'm looking for. Now, the next step is to identify what other information has been given using the diagram. Well, this angle here in blue, there it is. See it? And again, it's a tangent line and a chord. If I were to cut this into pieces, that would be a chord, right? It's more like a tangent secant theorem. You could call it the tangent secant theorem, but you notice it cuts the circle and do two arcs. Well, according to my pattern, the angle, so the measure of angle, we'll call this HK, actually, I'm just going to call it K. Measure of angle K equals half the measure of the arc HJK. This is the tricky part. The measure of angle K is half the measure of arc HJK. This is the algebra. So what's the measure of angle K? It's in blue. So you substitute. What's the measure of the arc I'm trying to find? It's up here. So... yeah, notice it's in parentheses, so it's, you write that as 1/2 times the quantity, 10x plus 50. Now, yesterday, Mr. Tucker and I, we got rid of the halves when it made things simpler. But in this case, it would make this left side more complicated if I multiply by 2. So watch. I now distribute the halves. And what's half of 10?
5.
Yeah, 5x. What's half of 50?
25.
Excellent. Woohoo. Man. All right, so, yeah, great job, guys. You're participating. I like that. I like that a lot. So here we go. Watch this. This is simple linear algebra. In other words, it's just, you know, you add, subtract, multiply, divide to solve for x. So let's subtract by 5x, right? What do we get? Good. Now, here's where, you know, you have to make that improvement. Where it says minus 29, do that now. Add 29. You can do two steps at once. Okay? That's perfectly acceptable. This is where you start taking shortcuts. Don't make mistakes, though. It's not a shortcut if you make a mistake. It's a wrong cut, okay? Like so with my haircut. Wrong cut. Anyway, super cut.
Okay.
And what's this, 54? Okay, divide by 3. What was it again, guys?
18.
So x is 18. Now, the directions said to find the missing arc, or did it say just find and solve for x? What were the directions? Let's see what it says here. We copied them before. Let's see. It says, using algebra, find the value of x. So I found the value of x, right? So I technically can stop there. I don't have to do anything else. So I won't. Could you find the arc measure, though, if you plug in x? They ask you to find it. Could you go 10 times 18 plus 50?
Yeah,
you could. But we're not going to do that, okay? Because it just said solve for x. And those are the directions that you had read, okay? So I'm going to stick to the directions. All right, I'm going to have someone read the directions. I'll call on you. Is there a volunteer? Wants to read it? Perfect. Yeah, finding angle measures. We got to find the measure of angle 1. Okay? Got to find the measure of angle 1. So I always say things backwards. Dyslexia. Okay. No, I don't, but it doesn't mean I don't say things backwards. So you ready? Check it out. I look at that diagram. I know there's a circle, but what else do I see in the diagram? I see two intersecting what? Ah, they're lines that they continue forever. Close.
No.
The chords. They're intersecting chords. Yesterday we wrote a theorem down. It's called intersecting chords theorem, or two chord theorem, I think. Something along those lines. The point was that when you have two chords that intersect, special properties occur, right? Here they are. Here are the special properties. Chord 1, chord 2. Okay, this is back in semester 1. We have special angles here. Anybody know their names?
Vertical angles,
yes. Vertical angles. Those are vertical angles. Are they congruent?
Yes.
Vertical angles are always congruent. So I got vertical angles. Now, here's the neat thing about these vertical angles. These vertical angles have corresponding arc measures because the angles create endpoints on the circle, or have endpoints on the circle, which create arcs. So you see that each of the vertical angles has a corresponding arc? Now, is that angle inside or outside the circle? So it's interior to the circle, which means that you add to find the angle measure. Let me explain that in more detail. The measure of angle 1, according to our theorem, was this, is half the sum of the two arcs. I underlined the two arcs. We know they're 75 and what?
25.
And that's what the theorem said. It's, hey, identify the vertical angles, find the corresponding arc measures, add those two arc measures together and divide by 2. So what's half of 100? And that's your answer. That's 50 degrees. What's the other angle? I didn't say to find it. What is it? If 1 is 50, what's this one? Also 50, right? Vertical angles are congruent. Yeah, I get that. Straightforward, simple, huh? Yeah? Okay, let's pause. Okay, so, again, guys, we're just about, to be honest, we've done a lot of questions and we're just about done with the practice assignment. So let's just push on through and get most of them done, and we'll take a short break, take some notes. So. Yeah, we'll see. I don't know if we have the time because I have to check notebooks. But here's what I do know, guys. I do know that we've seen this pattern, and I do know that the angle I'm trying to find, angle one, is exterior to the circle. Now remember, exterior, when you have that pattern, you subtract to find the answer, right? Subtract. You don't add like we did before, right? Yeah, like this one, look. This one was we added because the angle is on the inside of the circle. Where here, the angle is on the outside, and so we're going to subtract. So let's set that up. Let me get comfortable here. Slice some things around and move my wires here and set this up. So are you ready? Okay, so here's what I know. Hey, pay attention. I have something called 2 secants. So this is that 2 secant theorem. It's not what I wanted to do. Let's change that. Let's go here. There we go. That's what I wanted. So hey, secants intersect circles at 2 points, right? So watch. Hey. So when I identify those 2 points, your next step is to identify the arcs that are inside that angle called one. So, because there's 4 arcs total, right? I see 4 sections of the circle. So I'm going to identify the inside or interior arc. Okay? So now that I've identified those interior arcs, your next goal is to say, okay, I've got those arcs. Now, which one is the largest arc versus the smallest arc? The largest arc is here. So I identify that, and I write down what I'm going to do. I'm going to write down the measure angle one is going to equal half the difference of the 2 arcs. But when you subtract the difference of the 2 arcs, always start with the larger arc. I'll call it L. Right? Subtract the smaller arc from the larger arc. This would be like smaller or larger, okay? 105 minus 51 is 54. Yeah. And what's half of 54? 21. So it's the measure of the angle. Good stuff. This angle is 27. If you got an answer like 95, do you think it's right? Yeah, it was not right. Okay. Not right. Need a reader, so I'm going to call on, how about Liam? Will you please read those directions for me, please? Find the value of A, right? Yeah. So we're going to find the value of A. A is a variable. Let's find that missing variable. So here's what I recall. I remember that if I have a chord and a tangent line, right? That didn't work out good. Try that again. Okay, try that one more time. That's a little better. If I have a chord and a tangent line, and I'm looking for, it didn't work out very well either. And I'm attempting to solve for an unknown variable. Well, there's a relationship. That angle is always half the measure of the interior arc to the angle. This arc here is inside the angle. So let's write that property down. Let's write that pattern. So it goes something like this. It's the measure of the angle, I'll call it A, is equal to half the measure of the arc. So I wrote that pattern down just so I could see what's going on. So what's the measure of my given angle here? There you go.
Didn't we already do this before?
I think we did something similar to it. And that's going to equal half of the measure of the interior arc to that angle, which is 260. What's half of 260? So we've got this equation. Subtract tan right. Gives us 120. I'm writing sideways. Divide by 8. Answer's 15. One more question and we'll take a break. One more question. Una más. One more question and we'll take a break. Question. All right, last question. Okay, quickly I'll highlight what I see here and let you know that I have two secants intersect to form four separate arcs, but I'm only interested in the arcs that are interior to the angle. So I'm interested in this angle or arc measure, and I'm interested in this arc measure. And I need to find the value of A. This would be the angle. So I'll write down my information here. According to this pattern here, we're going to subtract because it's an exterior angle. So the measure of this angle is equal to one-half times the measure of the, I'll call it the large arc, minus the measure of the small arc, okay? That's interior to the given angle. Alrighty? So, let's substitute. I can do this. Angle A is A divided by 2. The large arc is here, which is A plus 70. Oops, I don't need that there. And I don't like that A, so fix it up there. Minus the other arc. And that's A plus 30, so got to group that as a whole expression. All right, so here's where we're going to use fraction busters, Mr. Tucker calls it. I like that. So let's get rid of the half because it seems like it's going to make things more complicated. So multiply everything by the reciprocal of a half, which is 2 over 1 or 2. Okay, then also I'm going to take this negative sign and distribute that through. Okay, so I'm doing a couple of things all at once. That's gone. We have A. This is also gone, and we're left with A plus 70 minus A minus 30. Okay? A lot of work, huh? Yeah. And that's why you need practice. Think about what you're doing. And, you know, I remember my pre-algebra teacher telling me that if I had on the same side of the equal sign, opposite term, A and negative A, you can just cross them off. Okay? And then now let's combine like terms, which means, you know, anything that has a like variable or is an integer or a fraction or a real number, you can combine them. So 70 minus 30 is 40. So A equals 40. I think it makes sense. All right, guys, that's the show. Take a quick break, and we'll go back at it with notes. 10.5, I think.